Second question is, what is the airspeed? We call it indicated airspeed, and you know indicated airspeed is, has a meaning, but it's basically an equivalent airspeed. It's basically relative airspeed, and this is the airplane speed relative to the medium. What is this airspeed for a stick fixed case? That means I have to see this graph. Right. These are all graphs of CM versus CL for a cruise flight. So trim is at CL equal to 0.8. First I identified it is a cruise flight, right? And CL trim is how much? CL trim is given by, for a stick fixed case, it is trimming at 0.8 CL, CL equal to 0.8. Now this has been conducted, test has been conducted in a wind tunnel. So I can take rho as 1.225 kg per meter cube. S will be required to find out S. Why I am doing all this thing? I want to calculate airspeed. I know for a cruise, V is equal to 2 W by S by rho V square. W is given? Yes, W is given. 700 kg. So I will write this equal to 2 and 700. Am I correct? I have to do something else. If I put 700, my problem will be okay? No, because this is in kg. I have to put in Newton. So I have to multiply by 9.8. Then divide by S, divide by rho. Oh, sorry, V will be equal to this by CL. Sorry, correct this. V will be equal to 2WS, edit, V will be equal to under root 2W by S, rho CL, okay? So S is there, rho is here, and CL I know is 0.8. How do I find S? That is, I have to use aspect ratio and span, you could see. Now I am trying to find out S. S is what? I have given aspect ratio, and aspect ratio is B square by S. Aspect ratio is given 6. Span is given how much? Span is given 6. So I can easily find out S. Okay? So S is known. Rho I know. Wind tunnel at sea level 1.225. So I can easily calculate this is the V trim, or what is the airspeed for a stick fixed case is this much, whatever value comes here. In my calculation, this value comes out to be around 48.33 meter per second, but you please check, right? This I have done in a hurry. My job is not to spoon feed you. You should be able to calculate this. I repeat again here, this S, I calculate like this from aspect ratio and span. Rho, I have taken 1.225 because the wind tunnel testing was done in a at a sea level condition, fair enough assumption, and CL is 0.8 because stick fixed case, this, right? Okay, so second question is over. Now let us go to third question. These questions are designed to see that you not only understand whatever you have been talking about, you should also understand the relationship between stick fixed and stick free. So what is the third question? Third question is, if the airplane or the aircraft was to be trimmed at indicated airspeed IAS, which you know, of 200 kilometer per hour, find the tap setting, find the tab setting required and also calculate DFS by DV. Two important questions are asked. Okay, is this question clear? The third question is, if the aircraft was to be trimmed at indicated airspeed of 200 km per hour, find the tap setting required and also calculate DFS by DV. When you say tap setting required, the meaning thereby is, after setting the tap, the pilot should fly hands off. Pilot should fly hands off means, the question is, what is that tap setting required so that stick force becomes zero? Both are equivalent questions, right? So we'll do that. We have to take help of these big expressions, but we'll try to give a better feel. I will not erase this part. I will try to solve this problem within this so that you can see the questions while I am solving. First of all, let us understand this 200 km per hour. So we have to convert this. V indicated or VI is 200 km per hour. I convert it into meter per second. And in my calculation, it comes around 55.55 meter per second. So this is 55.55 meter per second. VI, no problem. And the XCG, what is the XCG given? Any XCG is given here? The problem? This will be extremely important information. Yeah, it has to be given. This XCG given is 0.2C. Why suddenly I look for XCG? Because I know when you are developing, especially for stick force, remember we have to generate a moment about the hinge, right? And stick force and stability are related, like elevator deflection and stability are related, right? If overstable, then you have to put a lot of stick force to turn the elevator for a trim. So I need to know what is the XCG location, which by mistake I missed, but in the question I found, yes, it is there. So XCG is 0.2. So whenever you're solving a problem, please activate your mind on the physics of the problem, okay? Now, what is FS? FS is, let me write this, FS is K half rho V square A plus CH delta T into delta T minus K, I write here, minus K W by S CH delta E by CM delta E, this delta means elevator, into DCM by DCL free. Now what is the question? Question is, what is the value of delta T? That is, what is the value of tap setting angle? So what is the question? Question is, what is delta E? So that FS equal to zero. Right? That is the question. So now if I put FS equal to zero and this manipulate this expression, I will get delta T expression as 2 W by S 1 by rho V square 1 by CH delta T into CH delta E by CM delta E into DCM by DCL free minus A by CH delta T. Please understand what you have done. You have done nothing. We have to calculate delta T, and for delta T, FS has to become zero. So I put zero here and then do this algebraic manipulation to get this expression, which you can yourself find out. And if there is any mistake, you should be able to correct it, okay? For example, now I see a mistake here. This will be 2 W by S, 1 by rho V square, into 1 by CH delta T, CH delta E by CM delta E, DCM by DCL free minus, you know. Apparently there is no mistake. But you should be very careful, okay? So now what is required? Do you know W by S? Let us see. I will not erase this because you will be requiring this. do some trick, or you can use here. What is W by S? W by S, W you know, 700 divided by S. S you can find out, aspect ratio is B square by S equal to 6, and B is 6, that means 36 by S equal to 6. This implies S equal to 36 by 6, so it is 6 meters square. Okay, so I write W by S equal to this by 6. Is it correct? No, it's not correct, because W should be in Newton, so I have to multiply this by 9.8. Don't forget that. Okay, so this is W by S, that will come here. Rho, what is the rho? Rho will be 1.225, because we are talking about sea level condition. Next, CH delta T is given minus 0.003, that value comes here. CH delta E, minus 0.07 per degrees come here. CM delta E, is CM delta E given anywhere? Can you check? If it is not given, either you have to find out, or this should have been given. So let us see where is in the question, whether CM delta is given or not. Okay, CM delta is not given. So we cannot solve this problem. Is it correct? We cannot surrender, right? Let us see how to calculate CM delta E. Okay, we need to calculate CM delta E given the data there. CM delta E was given as minus AT or CL alpha tail into VH neta T into tau. What was AT? AT was CL alpha tail. Of course, we have to have three-dimensional value. Right? What is given here? CL alpha wing and CL alpha tail 2D is given, that is 0.1 per degree. But this formula wants CL alpha 2 tail three-dimensional. So what I have to do? CL alpha tail three-dimensional can be easily calculated, but CL alpha 2D tail by 1 plus CL alpha 2D by pi aspect ratio. I am taking E equal to 1. As simple as that, just mechanical job. You put the 2D value here, put the aspect ratio value pi here, you get CL alpha 3D. What is VH? What is VH? VH is ST LT by S C bar. Now let's see, ST is given or not. LT is given, 6.5 meter. So ST was missed. So ST is, let me write the value of ST. So there are other informations also given, which are required. So let's see, I'm writing here. For example, what is given is aspect ratio of the tail as 4, tail span B of tail as 2 meter, alpha 0 equal to minus 2 degree of the wing, this is of course of the wing, right? And also things are given like elevator area, S elevator as 0.5 meter square and LT is already 6 point, elevator chord, that is CE chord is 0.25 meter and delta E0 is given somewhere or not. Delta E0, let's also write here, delta E0 is given as 3 degree and other values are given, of course. So it's not a problem. As you solve the problem, you understand these data are required and you need to look for those data, right? So what we are looking for was, what is the trim tab setting required for Fs equal to 0? And we are calculating at a particular speed V, because we are trimming at that speed V. So we are trying to calculate, this is 2 W by S, W need a precaution, 700, the weight is 9.8, and S, whatever S of the wing is there, rho value you know, V value you know, CH delta you know, CH delta, you know, CM delta, you know, DCM by DCL free. Where from you get? You get from that graph earlier which you have given, is minus 0.07 minus A by CH delta T. What is A? What is A? If we check your notes, A is nothing but CH naught plus CH alpha into alpha naught minus IW plus IT, okay, plus CH delta into delta E naught, and all these given values are given. It's a trivial thing. You have to check the data set and put those values. But from your problem solving, if somebody asks you, what is that trim tap setting required to trim at speed V so that FS is zero, you need to ask for all this information. So this exercise is done to give you that feel, that you have to look for all this information, small information. But remember, these are not straightforward information. How to get CH alpha tail, how to get CH naught, these are Herculean tasks. You need to do exhaustive internal testing, especially hinge moment coefficients or hinge moment derivatives. All those in blackboard looks very simple to solve a problem, but to generate this data is a Herculean task. And a good airplane is designed provided these data sets are reliable. Okay? Now the second problem, we want to calculate DFS by DV at x is equal to 0.2. So let us erase this all so that we get some space. Let me write the problem. We want to calculate DFS by DV at XCG equal to 0.2. Please understand, it is extremely important. If somebody asks you a question, what is DFS by DV? Meaningless question, because you know, this has to be specific for other conditions also, but CG is extremely important, right? If it's overstable, then DFS by DV will give a large gradient. So how do I calculate that? That is the question. It's again very mechanical. As long as you understand things, it's just a question of putting some number. So what is DFS by DV? If you see the expression, so let us see DFS by DV. And before that, if you see my notes, you'll find FS is given as KW by S, CH delta by CM delta E into DCM by DCL free into V square by V trim square minus 1. And then we took DFS by DV, but that derivative was at V equal to V trim. And that expression was, just to take derivative, the expression was, let me write, it is 2k W by S CH delta by CM delta E, CH delta E also, same thing, DCM by DCL free into 1 by V trim. And if I take the derivative, then put V equal to V trim, say there only 1 by V trim will remain. So this is the expression. What is so great to calculate this? What I should know? I always know, I'm expert now, what is W by S. And I know that when I put W, I have to put in Newton. So I will multiply by 9.8 if the weight is given in kg. CH delta value is known, CM delta value is known, DCM by DCL free is also given. V trim, I know what is the V trim because I'm cruising at that point. So what is remaining? Only value of K. What is K? So simple it is and so straightforward it is that you feel you get bored solving such problem. All the expressions are big and very nasty looking expression, but when you also solve, you find it is very, very trivial. So what is K? K is minus G AC C neta T. That's all. You have to look for what is the value of G. If you are doing a real aircraft, you have to find out the value of G through experiment. AC is the elevator area, C is the elevator chord, NT is the ratio of dynamic pressure at the tail with respect to free stream dynamic pressure. Some numbers are given here, right? And it's simply K, you know here, you put the value of K, so you will get the value of DFS by DV at V trim, V equal to V trim. But understand one thing, solving this problem is very simple. But when you try to generate, let's say, value of G, You have to do a lot of experiments, right? And get the value of equivalent value of G. Similarly, when you want to do, use the CH delta E, CM delta E, all those derivatives, don't think these are just from a lookup table you can get exact values. You have to do wind tunnel testing, you have to go for flight testing, multiple flight testing, then finally you get these values accurately. The whole art and sweat lies in generating this number, not applying this number for some equation, getting some number. So equations gives you a feel, and you can extend your design, correct your design, but validation comes from actual flight tests or some part through wind tunnel, and the whole task becomes how do I generate this number, which mathematical model expects to simulate the real situation. That is the real challenge. Okay, I hope this example will give you some feel, and you'll enjoy doing these problems and enjoy the subject stability and control. Thank you very much.